Good morning, students. Here now we are doing the revision for chapter 2, 4 and 6. As we done the chapter 1, 3, 5 in the set A, now we are start this revision for this chapter. For that, here few filling the blanks I will cover for your revision. First blank is given here. A line has blank and points. A line has blank and point. So what is the line? Line is endless. Yes. So we will write here, line has no end point. Yes. No end point. No starting point. No ending point. Now, second, a blank can be measured. So which one we can measure? Line segment. Yes, because the line segment is a part of line. So line segment, so a line segment can be measured and it has starting point and ending point. Now we will see the next. A blank has only starting point. So that means the ending point we cannot measure, or it is indefinite. Yes, that is a starting point is, so this is in the ray, because what is the ray is starting point and the second ending point is, we cannot say where the ending point is. So that's why we represent with the ending point with the arrow, that is endless. It ray is going on a particular direction for the so long and long path. So that's why we say that it has no ending point, but starting point is fixed. That we can see. So that's why only the starting point, a ray has a only starting point. Okay. Now the next blank is, a blank line meet a point. So what is that? And here one more I give a clue that it creates, or it can it make a right angle. So what is that? You understand that perpendicular line. Yes, a perpendicular line meet a point. That means a perpendicular line, that means here if this line and this line. Yes, two lines are there. Line L, line M. And these two lines are meet a point. That is, we say the point P. They both lines are meet at the point P. And it makes a angle, right angle, 90 degree angle. Yes. So, this is the perpendicular lines meet a point. Now, the distance between two blank lines remains same throughout. That means that two lines are going side, and both lines throughout they are same. Yes, the distance between two lines remains same throughout. So distance remains same throughout. That means the both distance. Why it is given? See. So as you understand, these lines are parallel lines. So the distance between two parallel lines remains the same throughout. The distance between two lines are remain same. So we say as a this is a parallel line. If for example, if it is the distance is here the same, yes, but on the some extent the distance goes decrease, yes, so this is the same, but on some extent it meet at the point, so we cannot say this is a parallel. For a while you are looking this way, okay, only for this part we can say that in some extent it is a parallel line, but that's why it is written here the throughout, the distance between two lines throughout the remains same, that means a parallel.